How to balance the connecting rods, small end and the big end. First of all, you need one tool like that. This is full of scratches. I'm trying to don't scratch it at all. It has also scratches here, but okay, who cares? It's working fine. What you should be careful with, you have to count from the center of the bolt here down, and you have to count from the center of the bolt here down to be straight, equal. And when you start counting the connecting rods, you should not move this, because if you move it and make it a bit more up or more down or something, you're going to have different values. And if you're counting in 0.1 of a gram, like me, then definitely you're going to have difference. So you need to have the machine with the bearings here, so the connecting rod can make easily this movement, to be freely, to don't have friction anywhere, to be as less as possible the friction between the connecting rod and the tool. So to find the actual weight here, this usually, one second, because it came out, this is, we have this, it's coming also, this for a bigger end, the connecting rod, and there is here, there is a bearing, here there is a bearing, here there is a bearing, and here there is a bearing. When you make the balancing here, it's very good, actually, you should not gonna move anything, because you can have different values. And I'm saying again, if you're counting on grams, there is no problem, but if you're counting 0.1 gram, there is a problem. Yeah, pretty much that's it. This is the how to balance the connecting rods. Actually, in one case, you're like that, you're like this, and then you put on the big end here. First, you're counting all the connecting rods. On the small end, you're not touching the big end. All the connecting rods, yeah, with one hand, it's a little bit difficult. One second, sorry. Okay. First, you're putting it like that. Now, because missing the scale, it's not straight. You have to open it and make it straight. You are counting all like that. You put a number of the connecting rod to see which one has how many grams, to see which one's the most heavy and most light. And then when you finish from this one, you have to swap it to make it upside down. You have to put this one from this side to count the big end of the connecting rod. Plus, when you do that, you have to adjust this bracket here to be again straight, because we can have some difference. Sometimes. Yeah. Or actually now it's the difference because missing the scale. Never mind. So this is how to make balancing on the connecting rods. Keep in mind that always you can remove weight, you cannot add. So first you need to count all of them and then to balance it. That's it, thank you very much. Actually, you balance the small end, the front end, and you're counting complete the connecting rod as it is to see how much the difference and from where it's missing, from where is the difference. Is the difference from the center of the connecting rod? Is the difference on the small end, on the big end? At least me, this is what I'm doing. And then you're counting also the piston and the wrist pin, and then you're trying to make it as much as possible to be same grams. Usually, me, I'm doing it, has plus minus 0.15 of a gram, and I'm happy. Yeah, thank you very much.